Snakes are interesting reptiles that evoke a great storm of emotions in all of us. Some people admire their grace and plasticity, while others look at them with disgust and caution. This is not surprising because in many feature films and adventure stories, it is snakes that are often a danger to travelers. It can be an incredibly poisonous coral snake or a king cobra, as well as a surprisingly strong python or anaconda, which today is the largest snake living on Earth. In the movie Anaconda, a team of travelers on a voyage through the Amazon jungle encounter this agile and cunning predator, which forces them to fight fiercely for their lives. Today, it's the anaconda, which is the largest snake on the planet, and its 9-meter body looks indeed gigantic. However, everything is learned by comparison, and today's largest snake was far from being at the top of the food chain. Once upon a time, the entire planet belonged to enormous reptiles that inhabited almost every corner of the Earth. We are talking about dinosaurs, which undividedly ruled the land millions of years ago. These are the famous allosaurs, tyrannosaurs, and other massive and aggressive predators capable of bringing stupefaction and inspiring real fear with their mere appearance. It's not known for certain what caused the death of a vast segment of the dinosaurs. A meteorite, ice age, or global warming. But one thing is clear, that today's descendants of these animals are pale copies of their prototypes. A similar situation applies to reptiles. Even the most imposing anaconda or royal python would look like a small water snake against the background of one of the giants of the Paleocene, the Titanoboa. The Titanoboa, Titanoboa serragonensis, a now extinct snake that lived during the Paleocene epoch between 66 and 56 million years ago, is considered the largest known member of the snake suborder. About 58 million years ago, the monstrous-sized snake crawled out of the swampy jungles of South America and began to reorder the area, preying on various small dinosaurs. Weighing over a ton and measuring 15 meters, approximately 50 feet, the giant reptile could swallow an entire crocodile without expending any serious effort. What's most interesting is that until recently, scientists did not assume its existence. A shift in this area happened in 2002 when paleontologists discovered ancient fossilized remains in the Cerrejón mine of Colombia. One of the strata contained deposits of a tropical forest from the Paleocene epoch. It may have been one of the first tropical forests on the entire planet. In addition to fossilized leaves and plants, they found such enormous reptiles as could not even be imagined. Such a find attracted much attention, and the best minds in the field engaged in closer analysis. Further excavations led to the discovery of many remains, presumably belonging to several dozen individuals. Most of them turned out to be adult snakes after inspection, but there were small young specimens as well. Scientists continued to draw a portrait of the snake and came to some surprising conclusions. It was a really difficult task because snake skulls have a different structure in comparison to human skulls, and they're much harder to find undamaged. When an animal dies, the connective tissue decomposes and all the individual bones tend to disperse. They are also very thin and brittle and often break down. Since the Titanoboa is so large, as well as its skull bone, it's one of the few snakes that has actually made it into the annals of the fossil record. However, paleontologists were lucky and were able to find a large number of remains. Thanks to this, they were able to better understand how Titanoboa lived and looked. A life-size replica is now on display at the Smithsonian Natural History Museum in Washington, D.C., and a nationwide tour took place in 2013. Analysis of fossils dating back from 58 to 60 million years ago revealed interesting results. Based on extrapolations of body sizes made from excavated vertebrae, individual sections of the spine, paleontologists estimated that the body length of the average adult Titanoboa was approximately 13 to 15 meters, and the average weight was between 1,150 to 1,300 kilograms. For comparison, this is twice as long as the longest snake alive today, and four times as heavy as the giant anaconda. This is definitely a snake you wouldn't want to encounter. Titanoboa is closest in structure and behavior to modern anaconda or boa, but it's still unclear which of today's reptiles is its closest relative. It's estimated that Titanoboa may have had over 250 vertebrae. At least one nearly complete skull specimen has been recovered. The presence of such large numbers of individuals of the same gigantic size indicates that 13 meters in length were probably the norm for adults of this species. For comparison, adult anacondas are on average about 6.5 meters long, while a record-breaking anaconda is about 9 meters long. That said, no live snake has ever been found with a confirmed length of more than 9.6 meters. The Titanoboa is definitely a true titan against the background of modern reptiles. So, why did this prehistoric snake get so big? Well, that's the point. The area in which it lived was conducive to its growth. At that time, Colombia and Peru, the part of South America where this snake lived and preyed, were very hot and humid. In fact, the temperature would always be high, which allowed the cold-blooded to be active and feel comfortable. This was really useful for reptiles like the Titanoboa. Statistics showed that the size of the cold-blooded always increases in areas with high temperatures and high humidity. It's believed that the enormous size of the snake is also closely related to the climate of the Paleocene. In snakes, as in other poikilothermic, cold-blooded animals, the metabolic rate depends on the ambient temperature. To maintain normal growth, snakes must have the necessary amount of heat. Reptiles would need an exceptionally warm environment to grow to Titanoboa size, such as that characteristic of the Paleocene epoch. Titanoboa probably spent most of its time in the water. The sedimentary structure of the region's rocks and the preservation of water-loving organisms in the form of fossils in the strata indicate that the region was swampy. Likewise, modern anacondas spend most of their time in or near water, where they hide among vegetation in shallow water and ambush their prey. The Titanoboa likely had similar habits because the large size of the animal would make life on land difficult or impossible. One of the most interesting facts about the Titanoboa is that although it somewhat resembled the modern anaconda, it most likely did not hunt the same way anaconda did. Modern anacondas hunt by wrapping themselves around their prey and squeezing it to death. Titanoboa probably didn't do that. Rather, it would sneak up on its prey and bite into its vital points with one swift stroke. This immobilized and frightened the prey, and only then Titanoboa entangled its future food and slowly devoured it. Certainly, just like a boa, it was capable of squeezing its prey when necessary, although that was not the first option to hunt. The Titanoboa was likely to rely on a sudden and quick attack. One more interesting fact about this reptile is that it was a carnivore that hunted a wide variety of prey. The Titanoboa was truly omnivorous and preyed on a wide variety of inhabitants of the planet. It could eat many small reptiles and birds and even hunt crocodiles. This snake could definitely stand up to the crocodiles that are now found in abundance in the land of the Amazon and turn them into its snack. Interesting facts about Titanoboa. Here's some few simple facts that will allow you to wonder about these colossi from the world of reptiles. The Titanoboa is the largest snake in the world. It's the largest reptile currently known to scientists among all existing now and previously. Its length is about 13 meters, and its weight is 1,150 kilograms. The reptile existed during the Paleocene epoch of about 60 million years ago and has not survived to this day. The first fossils were found in 2009 in a coal mine in La Guajira, Colombia. Titanoboa ate relatively infrequently, but it could swallow an entire crocodile in one sitting. It's quite possible that they also formed part of the snake's diet, on an equal footing with small reptiles and even birds. After ingesting and eating such a crocodile, the Titanoboa could quite normally go without food for up to a year. The main habitat of these giant snakes is a warm region in the Cerrejón Formation in Colombia, in South America. Titanoboa is a compound name meaning titanium boa. According to scientists, it's the boa and anaconda that are the closest modern relatives of this colossal reptile. The enormous snake was a carnivore, which means that it ate meat, and its diet did not include various leaves, stems, or fruits. This carnivorous constrictor also ate other snakes, such as boa, cobra, python, and possibly anaconda. Amazing conclusion to be the past or the future. Interestingly, after the extinction of the dinosaurs, this animal, Titanoboa, was the largest predator on the planet's surface for at least 10 million years. However, the period of reign at the top of the food chain also came to an end, and snakes were forced to leave this pedestal. Today, they're preserved only as cave fossils or museum exhibits. However, this is not the end of the story, and some scientists have come to mind-boggling conclusions. The bottom line is that Titanoboa, like many other animals of the Paleocene epoch, loved warm and humid climates. The fossils recovered in Colombia also testify to this. This has led scientists to believe that tropical plants in the ecosystem as a whole can cope with high temperatures and high levels of CO2, which is another major problem due to the current trend of global warming. That is, the climate of planet Earth can gradually, after millions of years, return to the climate of the Paleocene epoch, so favorable for the development of giant reptiles. Plants and animals in the tropics may already have the genetic ability to cope with global warming today. If this is the case, there is a non-zero chance that snakes like the Titanoboa could come back to life and climb back to the top of the food chain. However, it's impossible to speak unequivocally because these guesses remain only at the level of distant theories. Well, at the end of the day, folks, I think we should be very happy that days of these little snakies are long, long gone. Well, at least for now.